class 7. In the last video, we had started with a new chapter in history, that was the rise and spread of Islam. Now in the last class, we learned about the place Arabia, where Prophet Muhammad was born, who was a founder of Islam. We learned about the life of Prophet Muhammad, how he received the first revelation. We learned how angel Gabriel spoke to him and revealed to him the message of God. And then Prophet Muhammad adopted a new religion, Islam, and went on to spread Islam. But then he was opposed by the Arabs because of his principles. He wanted to ban idol worship in Mecca. So he was forced to leave Mecca and go to Medina. He then migrated from Mecca to Medina. And there he preached Islam and he had many followers there. Though later, then he was welcomed back in Mecca, and there also he spread Islam in Mecca. In the last class, we also learned about the teachings of Islam, the basic principles or the five pillars of Islam, that is the Kalma, Namaz, Roza, Zakat and Hajj. And we also learned about the other duties that every Muslim has to perform. Now in today's class or today's video, we are going to stress on the spread of Islam and its impact on society. Now we also learned about Prophet Muhammad's death in the last video. He died in the year 632 AD. And by this time, the whole of Arabia had adopted Islam. And after the death of Prophet Muhammad, it was his successors who took the job of spreading Islam. His successors were known as the Khalifas or the Caliphs. There were about four important successors or Khalifas of Prophet Muhammad. The first one was Abu Bakr, who was the first Khalifa. He was also his close friend. Abu Bakr, after Prophet Muhammad, became the head of the Arab community. He ruled for many years. And during his leadership, they managed to bring Syria and Palestine under their control. After the death of Abu Bakr, the leadership or the next Khalifa was Omar. Omar tried to capture places like Jerusalem, Mesopotamia, Egypt, and Persia. So, from the east, they started slowly advancing in the west. Now, the countries around Europe, the people in the Western Europe, were frightened that the Arabs will capture their area. So what did they do? They formed an alliance, they formed a group, and they got together and defeated the Arabs. So Omar, as a Khalifa, did not succeed in capturing Europe. Omar ruled for about 10 years, and then the leadership or the empire was taken over by Uthman. Uthman belonged to the Umayyad dynasty. So, the son-in-law of Prophet Muhammad, that is Ali, was not happy with Uthman. So what did they do? The supporters of Ali, they murdered Uthman, and Ali became the next Khalifa. But for a short period of time, because he too was killed, and his son Hussein and the other family members were also massacred at Karbala, which is in Iraq. After this incident, Islam split into the Sunni and the Shias. Now who are these Sunni Muslims? The Sunni Muslims rely on the Sunnah, that is, they rely on the sayings and teachings of Prophet Muhammad only. Whereas the Shia Muslims, They were the followers of Ali and his son Hussein. So every year they mourn the killing of Ali and Hussein at Karbala. And this is done during the month of Muharram, which is the first month of the Islamic calendar. Then the entire empire or the caliphate was taken over by the Umayyad dynasty. The Umayyad dynasty ruled from 661 to 749 AD. This dynasty made Arabic their official language. Before this, they spoke different languages, also Hebrew. But soon after they took control over the empire, they made Arabic their official language. And secondly, Damascus in Syria became their capital. The Umayyad dynasty has ruled for almost 80 to 90 years, and they built many monuments. One of the important monuments that they built was the Dome of Rock, which is in Jerusalem. Now this Dome of Rock is built on the top of a foundation stone which is sacred to the Jews as well as the Muslims. The dome here, it was originally covered with gold. It is one of the oldest monument of the Arabs. The second monument built by this dynasty was the Umayyad Mosque or the Great Mosque. This is also one of the oldest and the greatest mosque of the Arabs. After this, the empire was taken over by the Abbasid dynasty in the year 749. Now, this period, that is from the 8th century to the 13th century, is called the medieval period in the Arab civilization, in the history, and it is also known as the Islamic Golden Age. Why it is called as the Islamic Golden Age? Because there was a lot of progress done in the field of science, art, literature, mathematics, astronomy, geometry, various other fields. We are going to learn about this in details in the same class. Okay? And this advancement reached its height during the rule of Harun al-Rashid. This dynasty changed the capital from Damascus to Baghdad. Harun al-Rashid has ruled for only 23 years, but there was a lot of progress, advancement done during his reign. Now, so we have learned about the different Khalifas who were the successors of Prophet Muhammad. And we learned about the two dynasties which took over after the Khalifas, the Umayyad and the Abbasid dynasty. So this is how they spread Islam to the other countries. Let us now see what was the impact of Islam in the society. Now, the impact in trade, first important point that we have to know here is that these Arabs, they excelled in horticulture, or they usually started growing crops at a small scale in the beginning, but later they could cultivate different types of fruits like lemons, dates, peaches, apricots, etc. And they used modern methods of farming. They did the farming scientifically, wherein they used a lot of fertilizers. They used methods like crop rotation or irrigation, which is used today. Next, they also could produce sugar from sugarcane, which was a great achievement in those times. They also had a very good pottery. They made fine quality pottery with various designs, very attractive. They also introduced textiles of cotton, silk and wool. Then all these products that was done, they had to be manufactured, and these products were soon after manufacture, they had to be traded. And they traded to countries like China, India, and various other countries near the Persian Gulf. And what did they trade with? Textiles, weapons, carpets, pottery. They were also good at metal work, okay? In gold, silver, copper, bronze, and iron. Baghdad was the most important center of the Arabs. Along with Baghdad, there was Bukhara and also Samarkand. Now let us learn about their contribution in the field of literature. The Arabs, you must be knowing, were a great patrons of learning. The Abbasid dynasty established a house of wisdom at Baghdad. And here, the Muslim scholars would translate the Indian literature, the Roman literature, the literature of the Greece into Arabic, wherein people could understand and learn about the civilization of the world. They could learn about the invention or contribution of the other civilization. The other universities were at Egypt, Cairo, and at Cordoba in Spain. The Arabs also set up libraries and madrasas so that children or students could achieve religious training. I told you this age is known as the Golden Age because of the literary works that were contributed. One of the important or the famous work was the Rubaiyat, written by Omar Khayyam, who is a poet and also a philosopher. Another important work written during those times, during that period, was Gulistan, written by Sheikh Sadi. And 1001 Nights, also known as the Arabian Nights, which is a collection of folk tales like Sindbad the Sailor, then Ali Baba and 40 Thieves, and Aladdin's Magic Lamp. Okay, so all these were written during that period. Now let us see what was their contribution towards the field of science and mathematics. The Arabs have contributed towards science. Ibn Sina was the greatest physician of those times. His famous writing, Canon of Medicine, gives us information about the effect of the environment on the life of the people. The Arabs have also contributed in the field of algebra. The Arab numerals 1 to 0 was also invented in those times, in that period. They have contributed in geometry, trigonometry, physics, chemistry. The sulfuric acid, the nitric acid, potash, alcohol was also invented by the Arabs. Astronomy. When the rest of the Europe believed that the Earth was the center of the universe, during that time, the Arabs were convinced that it was not the Earth, but it was the Sun, which was the center of the universe, and the Earth was revolving around it. Apart from this, the Arabs also opened public hospitals, psychiatric hospitals, where they treated patients who were suffering from schizophrenia, which is a mental disease, and they were successful also in conducting many surgeries. Secondly, they worked on the use of compass. They also advanced the principles of pendulum. So this was about their contribution in science and mathematics. Lastly, very important was their contribution in art and architecture. The Arabs formed a special architectural type of designs. They used these simple geometrical shapes to have floral and attractive geometrical designs. And this was used on pots, on cloth, textiles, wood, glass. Their work of architecture can also be seen on the different forts or the palaces that was built. One of the important palaces was the palace of Alhambra at Granada, which is in Spain. And secondly, we have seen about the Dome of Rock and the Great Mosque. Apart from this, there are the other palaces or the other monuments that have been built all over the world. So the Arabs have also contributed towards the art and architecture. So in this chapter now, we have learned about the rise of Islam. And today we learned how Islam was spread to different places, different countries, and what was the impact or contribution of Islam to the society. With this, we come to the end of this chapter. Thank you.